passage where Jesus is brought before, you know, just right before Jesus is crucified and he has to be judged. And he is talking and then revealing himself, revealing the truth. But some people still don't recognize the truth. So what is the truth? Because most people, most Christians, work in the field of God and sometimes they don't even know the truth. They walk with the Lord, but they still don't know the truth. Amen? And the fact is that they base facts that they see as the truth. They use the facts as the truth. So when I say what is the truth, it's opposed to fact. I'll give you an example. The fact that you are born on your birthday is not the truth. It's just a fact. Hallelujah. Amen. Because God knew you were being born before, and that is the truth.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Amen. So the age that's on the paper is just a fact. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Because if that wasn't the case, Sarah could not have had a child. Hallelujah.
Amen.
That's the one thing we need to understand between the truth and the fact. If we go by the truth, there is no limit.
Amen.
But if we go by the fact, there are limits. Then you're going to see, in the fact, Sarah could not have given a birth. She was almost 100 years old.
Mm.
That's the fact. It wasn't the truth.
Amen.
Because the truth has no limit. The truth is Jesus.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
So we need to understand this morning. Pilate, you say Pilate? How do you say in English?
Yeah.
Pilate. Okay, we say Pilate in French. Pilate comes in front now to judge Jesus because they brought Jesus. But he is finding himself in a very tricky position. Jesus, who is being judged, is calm, but the one who is judging is agitated. Why? Because he cannot recognize the truth. That is the reason why I always tell people, do not enter into debate with people. Because people will bring you to accept fact as truth. Why? We have to walk by the truth.
Amen.
Hallelujah. And this is what we're going to see here. That the one who looks like he has the authority, because he has authority to make Jesus to be king. He has the power that time. But he didn't have the truth. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And because he has no truth, he's going back the fact. Jesus was accused. The story said this. The paper said this. So the decree is like this. So he has to be killed. But if he had looked for the spirit of God, the truth of God, because the spirit is called the spirit of truth, he would not have done this. It is by the fact that he based himself on. So what I want to say this morning is to tell someone that be very careful how you walk with God. Are you walking by the fact, looking at your circumstances, looking at your life, to think that you are walking with the truth? If your life determines your truth, then I'm telling you, you don't know Christ Jesus. Because Christ Jesus is the only truth.
Amen.
And he doesn't look at the fact. It means that he doesn't look at the circumstance. He doesn't look at what you're going through. He doesn't look at your cries. He's only looking at the purpose of God. What does God want to do with you?
Amen.
We have a bad perception of the truth most of the time. The truth is God. And it never changes. What God says he's going to do, he does it. It's the fact comes into place because we want to see things the way we have imagined it. The way we have planned it. But is it the plan of God? You plan to have something at the end of the month. And it's not coming. Maybe God planned it to come after the end of the month. Amen? That's the reason why when you walk by the truth, time has no point, it's not a problem for you. Hallelujah.
Amen.
You shouldn't worry about the time. You shouldn't worry about how things would come. Look at me sitting there, I didn't expect anything yesterday. My accountant was there. And I think he's even been there since the 24th. Because I don't, you know, check. You see? But what I'm trying to say here is that this is the truth.
Amen.
Because the fact was telling me something else. By the fact I received the letter, I knew that this letter says this. It is the fact. But actually, the truth was in the inside and it was different from the fact. Do you understand? What I'm trying to say here is where the Lord tells us that if you believe, you have received, then it shall be yours. What are you believing in? In the truth. But then you believe in the truth 1 minute, The next minute you turn to the fact. Yes, I believe that I am blessed. I believe I am healed. It hurts. Excuse me. You are believing in the fact. You don't believe in the truth. If you have confessed the truth, you don't believe in the fact anymore. Let the pain be there. Let whatever is there be there. Let the situation that is locked there. When you start confessing the truth, you say, I know you are there, but for me, you are not there. Because the truth said so. Hallelujah.
Amen.
This is how you're going to see the manifestation of the power of God in your life.
Amen.
So what is the truth? Your truth is not my truth. You can come here and say that the rock is liquid. You know, someone stood up one day and called this puppet. I can come here and say mango. I can go in my own world and start all over. I call this mango, I call this baby, and I call baby adult. Who can stop if I start my own little world? You know, we have sects who start all over there, and that's what they do. They change, they rename things. It is their truth. It is my truth. But it's not because I'm going to say that a rock is liquid that it will change what a rock is before God. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And that's what we do sometimes. What God has not said, you start naming it your own way. And you even say that God says so. It doesn't change. Rain will remain rain.
Amen.
Amen?
Amen.
The sky will remain the sky. You can call sky earth and earth sky. But God knows how he has planted and put things. Amen?
Amen?
So we need to be very careful about the perception of the truth. Let's go first and read John 18 from verse 28 to 40. In Jesus' name. What is truth? Can you read it, please? It's the long one.
Then the Jewish leaders took Jesus from Caiaphas to the palace of the Roman governor. By now it was early morning, and to avoid ceremonial uncleanness, they did not enter the palace because they wanted to be able to eat the Passover. So Pilate came out to them and asked, "What charges are you bringing against this man?" "If he were not a criminal," they replied, "we would not have handed him over to you." Pilate said, "Take him yourself and judge him by your own law. But we have no right to execute anyone," they objected. This took place to fulfill what Jesus had said about the kind of death he was going to die. Pilate then went back inside the palace, summoned Jesus, and asked him, "Are you the king of Jews? Is that your own idea?" Jesus asked, "or did others talk to you about me?" "Am I a Jew?" Pilate replied. "Your own people and chief priests handed you over to me. What is it that you have done?" Jesus said, "My kingdom is not of this world. If it were, my servants would fight to prevent my arrest by the Jewish leaders. But now my kingdom is in another place." "You are a king then," said Pilate. Jesus answered, "You say that I am a king. In fact, the reason I was born and came into this world is to testify the truth.
Amen.
Everyone on the side of truth listens to me."
Amen.
"What is truth?" retorted Pilate.
"What is truth?" Pilate is asking. But that guy probably really wanted to know the truth.
Mm.
That's the thing. Sometimes we ask him this, but listen to what Jesus said. You know the truth if you know him. Continue.
"What is truth?" retorted Pilate. With this, he went out again to the Jews gathered there and said, "I find no basis for a charge against him. But it is your custom for me to release to you one prisoner at the time of Passover. Do you want me to release the king of Jews?" They shouted back, "No, not to him. Give us Barabbas." Now Barabbas had taken part in an uprising.
Amen.
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 Let's give a clap to the Lord for his word. You see, the perception of the truth. Jesus is actually revealing who he is here. And this is what we do. When you go somewhere, they start challenging you, you deny the truth. He knows that revealing the truth, staying on the truth, speaking about the truth, his head will be cut off. But he remained on the truth. He's not trying to escape. We just heard the testimony of our sister there. This man is there. offer your body to me.
She said, ma'am.
She stood on the truth. How many times do we accept to compromise the truth? How many times? How many times? You stop doing what pleases man. You stop doing what pleases others. But the truth, leave it aside. Jesus knew. He's the truth. He is standing in the truth. That's what the perception of the truth is. If you have the truth in you, you will do the will of God. But when you don't, then you do your will. It means if you truly have Jesus in you, you will do the will of God. Because when you want to do something wrong, the Spirit of God, the Bible says the Spirit of truth will tell you, hey, what are you doing? What are you doing? The first reflex you will have is, hey, let me run away. And we heard, she preferred to go and stand waiting for a bus. That is the reason why God has to set a cab for her. But what do? We accept to go by the fact. Actually, this is the fact. I am here, so why not do it? So why not do this? And we abandon the truth. But yet we want the truth to serve us. It's not going to work. Amen?
Amen?
Jesus knew what was happening. And Pilate is standing there thinking, what am I going to do? But he's still asking for the truth. Does he really want to know the truth? He doesn't want to know the truth because he has the truth in front of him. He cannot recognize. If he recognized the truth, he wouldn't ask, what is truth? He did not recognize the truth because he did not have the truth in him.
Amen.
It's the same for you and me today. You cannot recognize what God is doing in your life if you still don't have Jesus in you. It doesn't mean nothing. You know, I want you to remember this. Sitting in a church building does not make you right before God. It doesn't make you know the truth. Because the truth has to live in you. How do I say that? The truth has to live in you. Why? Because the truth has come to live in you already. The Holy Spirit is the Spirit of truth. Now I want to speak about the power of the truth. The power of the truth is there to set us free. You know, sometimes we think that compromising sets us free. It sets you free from that little moment where you were pressed. But then I'll tell you what. Whatever you did not do in truth will follow back. And there are consequences. That is the reason why many Christians are suffering. That's the reason why many Christians are not seeing God's mighty hand acting in their lives. You know, I will tell you something today. God is not a man to lie.
Amen.
God does not lie. What he says for your life is what is going to happen. You know, every single day, every year, I say, Lord, this body, your spirit is in this body.
Amen.
Your spirit dwells in this body. Amen. Sickness has no space in my body. In Jesus' name. So if it comes, it has to go the way it came. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Because I base it on what? The truth. The word of God. But I don't wait until things come. When the facts are there, I start panicking. No. I don't panic. Because I know the truth. Hallelujah. You know, it's what you're confessing to God that will come to you. If you confess fear, why God says that the spirit of fear is not part of you, you are confessing what is contrary to God's will, and you want God to act, you're not in the truth. Jesus was bold. Be bold. Jesus was courageous. Be courageous. Why would you be the kind of person who is afraid of, oh, if I do this, they might think this? Who are you? Who are you? Jesus knew what was going to happen when he says the truth. But he stood firm on that truth. And this truth set him free. You know, the fact that his freedom was a cross. Hallelujah.
Amen.
He could have escaped the cross. This was the right time for him to escape the cross. What are you talking about? When they said, so you are saying you are king? He said, well, in fact, I am. In fact, I am. If it were you and me, you say, hey, in my head, there's a burger. I rather choose burger. Let's wait for the cross. You know? So we need to understand what the cross means. you're gonna say, how can someone be set free if he's gonna suffer?
Yeah.
My friend, if he did not suffer, he wouldn't have been glorified.
Mm.
Amen.
Amen.
And you and me wouldn't be saved.
Amen.
You and me wouldn't be saved. But he was glorified. And his name is today the name that's above all names. Do you think that it came like that?
He had to go through the cross.
You want the glory of God, you don't want the cross? Mm. It will never gonna happen. The first point is live by the truth and not by the fact.
Amen.
Live by the truth, which is Jesus Christ, which means live like he lived. Accept the cross. Accept to say no to the world. Accept to say no to compromising. Accept to say no, no, and no. The word of God says this, I'm going to do this.
Amen.
Not that. When you start there, then you're going to also see the glory of God in the land of the living.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Because God is not a man to lie. John 8 verse 32, what does it say? John 8, did I put it there? I just put that one. Okay, you can read it the whole. John 8, 32. If someone has it, can you read it very quickly? Find it for me, please. It says, the truth, this is where I'm talking about, the truth has the power to set us free. Hallelujah. When Jesus said to Pilate and the people who were there that, you know, look at his boldness. He's going to be chopped off. And then he's like, you know, guys, you cannot do this if the one who sent me doesn't give you the power. Can't you say that to your employer? Don't think that I am here because you want me to be here. I am one who is above you.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
But when we go in the world, we become like, how do you call it? Comment on appelle la serpillère? A mop. Yes, that's what we become. A mop. They're using us to mop the floor. Move like this, you go. Move like that, you go. That's what they do with us in the world. It shouldn't happen. Because of the position we have in Christ. I told you, I was in a school once. Someone, every day she would change to my line manager. I said, if you do this again, I will resign. She did it on Friday, after three times. Warning her. Monday, I brought the letter. I said, okay, yes, I'm going. She thought I was joking. I'm not a mop. I'm a child of God.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
They should not use you as a mop. Of course, it's not about being disrespectful. It's knowing who I am.
Amen.
Because when I did that, you know what? She was now, what can we do for you to stay? I said, I'm not staying anymore. I'm going. I'm going to find another school.
Amen.
You did not appreciate who I am. I was. Let me go where they will appreciate me.
Amen.
Because we are afraid of things to come. We are afraid. Do you know your God? Can your God abandon you? The brothers of Joseph thought he was killed. Eh? They thought that he was finished.
Mm.
But God removed him and took him up there.
Amen.
Because the plan of God will come to pass anyway.
Amen.
No matter what man does.
Amen.
So even if you are in a position, nothing is working, just say, whoa, you know what? If you can't appreciate me, let me move. Continue who you can use as a mop. Because somewhere, someone will see the golden, hey, child of God I am. Hallelujah.
Amen.
You need to know who you are. That's the truth. The truth is who you are in Christ. Gold. Queen. King. In this world.
Amen.
But don't let the world use you as a mop. Amen.
Amen.
That's how Christ set us free. Can someone read John 8 verse 32? Thank you.
Yes.
Go ahead.
Then you'll know the truth, and the truth will set you free.
Amen. If you know the truth will set you free. My second point, the truth has the power to separate.
Amen.
Amen. Can someone take John 17, verse 17? You know, it is by the truth that we are sanctified. Do you know that? By the truth. You know what sanctified means? It's to become holy. You cannot be holy with lies. Yeah? Lies will not make you holy. When you're living a life of lie, a life of pretense, you can't be sanctified. You need the truth. Let's read John 17, verse 17. Amen? Yes? Can you read this?
Me?
Yes.
Sanctify them by the truth. Your word is truth.
Amen. The word of God we know is the truth. So the word sanctifies us, and the Lord sanctifies us by the truth. But people want to live in lies. I will tell you and remind you that the Bible says that if you're not holy, you're not going to see the God of heaven. You're not going to enter the kingdom. So use the word to sanctify your life. Use God, you know, every provision God has already made for your own sanctification. No one is asking you to wear a white garment or to go in the river and wipe yourself. You know? That will not sanctify you. Burn all the candles in the world. It's not going to sanctify you. No. It's only the blood of Jesus that does it.
Amen.
And Jesus is the truth. So the only sanctification is through Jesus. So you need to know him. Live like him to be sanctified.
Amen.
Amen. In a life of obedience. Amen.
Amen.
Next point, the truth has the power to strengthen you. Many times I hear people saying, oh, I need strength. What strength do you need? What strength do you need? Let's read John 4, verse 24. You see? The woman at the well is coming. And Jesus is saying that the truth will make you want to worship. It's the truth that will bring you to closer to God.
Amen.
And when you're closer to God, you cannot be tired. Whenever you get tired of following the Lord, I'm telling you the truth, it's because you are far from the Lord. You've known me, some of you, 3-4 years. Have you ever seen me tired? Have you ever, one day, one single day, like one split second? No. Because I will tell you the truth today. My truth, not the truth of the Bible. My truth is that I cherish my relationship with God.
Amen.
In a way that, man, you have no space. Even my children have no space. I cherish it. I have decided to cherish it. My relationship with God. I don't want man to intervene.
Mm.
I don't even want my own passions to intervene.
Mm.
I don't want myself to even block it.
Mm.
That is how I live. Because what I have, you know, the Bible said, test me. Test God. I tested God. I said, no, it's too good, man. I'll stay here. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Test him. The day you do, test God. No one will tell. You can never be tired of worshiping him. It's even if I'm not going to be able to, it bothers me. The other day I was going to Paris. I called Pastor Jared, do you have service on Friday? I am the one calling him. No, if there is on Thursday, do you have any service? You will go and start just, you know.
Yeah.
Where I go, I don't want to know where I'm going to worship.
Amen.
Why?
Amen.
Why? That's how I am. Because it's just part of me. It's no longer separate. That is why you see me always full of energy.
Amen.
Day and night. Because the truth will invigorate you. The truth will give you the strength you need to sustain the pressures of life. Don't you think I have pressures? I do. But where I'm sitting, there's no pressure.
Amen.
I'm sitting by the truth. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And when I'm sitting, pressure comes, the truth tells me, do not worry about anything. And I hear it, I'm like, I'm not worried, your God.
Amen.
I know you will take care of it.
Amen.
When, how, when is none of my business. You know, I was in Paris. I went on Wednesday. Was it Wednesday? Thursday, I'm walking. I finished. I have an appointment at 9:45. And I had another one at 4:30. And then I was walking. I'm like, Lord, I need £10,000. Because that's, you know, my communion, that's what the relationship is. I speak to him, I'm walking. If it's you, you go and take pictures and tourists. While I'm walking, I'm speaking to him. I say, Lord, I want £10,000. Because I have all this to do. It's for your work.
Mm.
I came, I found 2,000 already there. And I know that by July, the time I gave him, I'll get help.
Amen.
And if I know this one is already paying for India.
Amen.
That's the reason why I don't go and start buying myself clothes. Because I'm like, yeah, I need to go to India in May. I'm you know, hey, I need about 1,500. To people less, I will receive about 1,400 and something.
Amen.
So you see, this is the God I'm talking about. Where do you live? Where do you sit? Why are you worried? You worry about what? Because you're far from the truth. If you worry, you're far from the truth. Because your eyes are in the world, not in there. When I need something, I didn't come to you like, my friend, please, let's come put money together because I need to go to India. That's what I said to someone one day. My goal is to be. When I do projects, I don't look at how it's going to be financed. I just plan it.
Amen.
Because I know that the one who sent me will manage to get the money. I don't want to know how.
Amen.
If he wants, he's going to knock to my next door neighbor. But I will receive it on due time.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
The truth. That's what the truth is. That's the reason why you see that I have an urge to follow and to serve the Lord. Because it cannot go. Praise the Lord that way. Accept to go through the standards of the Lord, the principles of God. Hallelujah. Can someone read John 4, verse 24, please?
God is spirit, and his worshippers must worship in spirit and in truth.
Amen. Most of the time, we don't do it in truth. We do it just in presence. I'm here. So what? If you're not doing the worship of the Lord in truth and in spirit, something will miss in your worship. You know what worshiping means? Worshiping is communion. Communion means, if you take the Latin origin, come and become one.
Amen.
Are you one with God when you're sitting here? That's the truth. That's what God wants. He wants to feel his heartbeat. Can you believe that? God the Father, he wants you to feel his heartbeat. And you're there worrying about things of the world. You know, worrying about your little situation. And how can you feel his heartbeat? You know, when you're in love, people, you feel. You can feel what someone is going through without speaking. That's how God, that's communion. That's worshiping. When you're sitting there, God will tell you someone needs this, someone this. Because your heart and his are connected. That's the truth. But people today want power. The power to speak the word to people. The power to preach. The power to say, yeah, God sent this. God sent this. That's not what God wants. God wants us to worship with him. The first thing he told Adam and Eve is, where are you? The only thing God wants is that. He doesn't want you to get it. You know, all these things he gave us is secondary. That's the reason why I don't come here and prophesy every day. I don't come here and say the name of Jesus. You know, every single day before I come, I know the situations of everyone. You know why? Because before I come and prepare myself, I say, Lord, speak to me. Tomorrow I'm going to stand before your people. What's going on? He will tell me. Sometimes I don't even ask. Did I ask for my cousin in Paris when he revealed to me that she was pregnant? And that what was going on with the father of the child? No. And I started praying on the way the Lord showed me. This man who refused the child called her finally that he's going to come and visit her this weekend.
Amen.
Did I know even that she was pregnant? No. She was even trying to hide it from me. But God told me the story. He told me the situation. And then I said, I'll pray the way the Lord showed me. And I've been praying. And she called me. She told me I was with her this weekend. And he wants to come.
Amen.
Someone who refused, he said, no, you are pregnant. You know, God. God is amazing. You need to, that's the truth. Living by the truth is not seeking the miracles of God. It's not seeking the blessings of God. It is seeking the truth, Jesus. Amen. And when you meet him, you become a Zacchaeus. The world has no more meaning. Nothing in the world will impress you. And I will tell you the truth. It's the time you get there that God started even blessing you. Yes. When I was praying for finances before, I didn't get anything. Yeah? I was even frustrated myself that when I go somewhere, he blesses people. Say, Lord, you bless them, but what about me? Yes, I did those prayers. I'm a human being. You are using me to bless, but what about me? Then I stopped. I said, no, no, no. Everyone has their time. This speaker doesn't have the same length. Regine, your time will come. Seek him more. Maybe you're not doing the right stuff.
Amen.
Change. I didn't go like, yeah, the Bible says it. No, I looked at myself. Maybe it's me. Maybe there's something I'm not doing right. What should I do? Seek the truth. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And the truth will invigorate you. The truth is something that is told in the world. You know what? If we don't have the Bible, whatever we believe in does not exist. So that's the reason why we believe every word in the Word of God. Some people prefer to say that they don't want the Old Testament or they don't want the New Testament. If you don't want the Old Testament, then it's like you are refusing the foundation. So it cannot work. If you don't want the New Testament, you are refusing the truth. Because Jesus is the truth.
Amen.
That is revealed. You are refusing the revelation. Amen. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So you need the foundation and you need the revelation to be whole again.
Amen.
You need both to be whole again. And that's what the Bible is for us. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So everything in the Bible stands and falls in the right place. There's nothing in the Bible that would not come in this world.
Amen.
If God says something and you're not doing it, my friend, you're not in the truth. Many things he said in the past have already happened and more to come. So you make sure that you know what the truth is. Because the question today is, what is truth? Are you living by the fact? Like many people, I watch the news, but the news are not commending me.
Mm.
It's not because they're going to say there's an economic crisis in the UK, no one has salary. I say, well, then it's for them.
Amen.
It's for them. Me, the Bible says the contrary. It says that 1,000 will fall, 10,000 will fall, I will remain standing. And I stick by that truth. And I walk by that truth. And I believe that truth. And I know that truth will work for me.
Amen.
In Jesus' name.
Amen.
That's how God wants us to work. You know the reason why some people's situations are blocked? Because they don't seek the truth and they refuse the truth. They live by their own truth. And their eyes is on the truth of the world. That's the reason why nothing is changing. Nothing is happening. Amen?
Amen.
The truth is the truth. And the Bible is the truth.
Amen.
If you believe in the Bible, you sit on it. You walk by it. You're going to see how God is going to work in your life. Hallelujah. Because we have a Savior. The only one. Muhammad is not going to come and save. Even the Muslims are waiting for Jesus. It's written in their Quran. They are waiting for Jesus. Why are they not waiting for Muhammad? Because Muhammad is in the tomb. Jesus.
Amen.
Amen.
Give a clap to the Lord.
Amen.
But the difference between them and us is that they don't have the revelation of the truth.
Amen.
They know they are waiting for Jesus, but they don't know why.
Mm.
And the fact is that when Jesus comes, it will be too late for them. But you today, you know why you're waiting. The truth reveals the why of things. That's what the world does not have. The why of things. The Bible says in 2 Corinthians, can you put it up for me please, Jules? 2 Corinthians 4, that the world has a spirit within them which blinds them to the truth. 2 Corinthians 4, verse 4. You see, they don't know the why of things. So, and because man always wants to know why, man starts inventing the reasons to that why. It makes sense now. Because if you don't know, you will invent. Those who don't know God, because they refuse to know God, they will rather invent something. They will rather invent. Can you read 2 Corinthians 4 verse 4, please?
The God of this age has blinded the minds of the unbelievers so that they cannot see the light of the gospel that displays the glory of Christ.
Amen.
With the image of God.
They cannot see. They cannot see, they are blind. So imagine a Christian living by the scars of the world. You cannot see the same thing. That is the reason why you will live a life of frustration being a Christian. A life of I don't understand. A life of I don't know. A life of jealousy. Because you see the others receiving. The others moving forward. And like me. No, it's not about you. It's about the truth. Get the truth. Settle on the truth. Walk by the truth. Accept the truth.
Amen.
Of the word of God. Amen?
Amen?
Is it the truth that sets you free?
Okay.
It's not what Regine has. It's not what you see. Because what I have is what you see.
Amen.
It is the truth that will set you free.
Amen.
From whatever you are going through. Amen?
Amen?
I remember my mom once telling me, you know, and even recently I remember my auntie telling me that, you know, we have an auntie who is, those who read my book know, who is very, you know, doing things weird stuff. And then my mom is like, you know, I don't know what my this woman did to my daughter. My auntie said, do you know Regine? You know who you're talking about now? And then I called my mom and said, hey, if those things are touching you, you cannot touch me. I'm no longer there. Before I was there. But she cannot even approach me anymore. Where I am sitting, I'm too high and she's too in the darkness. We cannot meet. There's no way. The Bible says that Lazarus is the rich man. One is in heaven, one is in darkness. They could not reach. And he said that there's no way.
Mm.
There is no way.
Amen.
My friend, if I know that, what can you tell me that someone is trying to harm me can do?
Amen.
Because before you touch me, you need to fight Jesus. You have the strength. You have to fight the truth. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So if now I decide to move down there in fear of what man can do to me, how can Jesus himself defend me? If I now start walking by the standards of the world, so you are high place, you lower yourself in a position in the mud, and you want Jesus to come and get you there. You say, you want the mud, let me leave you there 5 minutes. When you taste the world and then you are a bit fed up, maybe then I'll come back for you. That's why we suffer. Amen? The people in the world are blinded. They don't have the truth. Can we read 1 Corinthians 2 verse 14, please?
The person without the Spirit does not accept the things that come from the Spirit of God, but considers them foolishness,
yes,
and cannot understand them.
Amen.
They understand only through the Spirit.
Amen.
Amen. That's the reason why the people who don't have the truth will tell you, you're fooling. You're fooling. How can you give so much money in church? How can you be going to church every day? How can you do that? For them, it is foolishness. You know the reason why? Because they don't have the truth. They don't have the light in them. So they cannot understand. Why do you want to debate with such a person? Amen?
Amen.
That's the reason why I don't debate. I don't debate the word of God. Now, look at this. What does the Bible tell us? Go on John 14 verse 17 again, please.
Shall I read?
Yes, please.
I'll read it in English. If you love me, keep my commands. And I will ask the Father, and he will give you another advocate to help you and be with you forever.
Amen.
The Spirit of truth.
Thank you. Let's stop here. The Spirit of truth. If you love me, the day you accept Jesus Christ, that Spirit of truth comes in you to help you, to be your advocate. Amen. So that Spirit is already in you. But now, why do we live in conflict? The Spirit of truth is in me, and I live in conflict with the world. It's because, actually, your eyes are set on the world, and you don't want the truth. You know, you can have 1 million here and live as a warm, homeless person because you don't know the value of that 1 million. You know, there are people, you give them a nice dress, they don't know that this is a party dress. You see them in the tube with it going to work. You know, you give them a dress like a party dress. You see them, where are you going? Going to work, they don't know the value, and they will not explain the value. Do you understand what I'm trying to say here? Because they don't know the value of Christ. They don't know the value of the truth. They already have the truth in them, but they don't know the value. So they continue doing as if they don't have the truth. And they don't understand nothing is working. The Spirit of truth who lives in someone has to influence the life of that person to live by the truth. Not to live in the world. Not to have their eyes set in the things of the world. Not to desire the things of the world. If your eyes are still in the world, then truth is still not in you. Or the truth is in you, but you are that person who does not know the value of what you have received. Amen? It's simple. It's two ways. Either it is not, and you are still in the world, or it is there, but you don't know the value of the truth. Continue, please.
Spirit of the truth. The world cannot accept him because
thank you.
It neither sees him nor knows him. But you know him, for he lives with you and will be in you.
Amen.
Glad to the Lord. Now tell me that you know the truth and you live like a worldly person. There's a problem. It's impossible. If it is possible in your case, then you have a problem because the Spirit has no problem.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
All he wants is to do what he has come into you for, which is lead you so that the plan of God will be fulfilled
Amen.
In your life.
Amen.
And you will have a life full of the abundant life that Jesus has talked about.
Amen.
Amen?
Amen.
Let's read again. John 15 verse 26, please.
When the advocate comes, who I will send to you from the Father, the Spirit of truth, who goes out from the Father, who will testify about
him. Amen. So the Spirit of truth testifies about Jesus in us.
Amen.
So you have, he has to tell you, Jesus doesn't like this, so don't do it. Jesus like this, don't do it. How come some people go ahead like they don't have the Spirit of truth in them? It's a problem. Let's read the next one. John 16, verse 13, please.
For when he, the Spirit of truth, comes, he will guide you into all, speak on his own. He will speak
But there's only one truth. And the Bible says, when the Spirit comes, He will guide you into all the truth.
Amen.
All the truth of God. All of Jesus. Not your truth. Your truth is limited to what you know. I will give you an example. I have been to Haiti. Many of you have never been there. All of you anyway. That's the truth. But it's my truth because maybe someone went, even in spirit. Do you see what I mean? It's my truth because I don't know. Maybe one of you can say, no, I was actually born there. You know what I'm saying? I can come here and say, no one has ever went. It's like, no, I was there once. I flew. Exactly. Do you understand? So I went there. I know how people are living there. I can come here and give you a whole opinion. My truth. Then someone else comes. Oh, I hate the Haiti. You know I like Haiti. I will give only opinion, a truth that is based on what I saw. The best example is in the Bible. When the 10 explorers went to explore the promised land, they all saw the same thing. Amen? Only two did not see the giants. Only two came up with a different report. Where was the truth? Amen. That's the best example. The other saw the giant were going to eat us. And they brought fear in the lives of people because their eyes were worldly. They saw things worldly. The others went by the Spirit and in truth, and they saw the truth and the Spirit.
Amen.
How do you see things out there? There's lack of work. You start panicking, worldly attitude. You are like the 8 ones. You're not like the 2 ones. Only the 2 entered the promised land. All the others died. So there are many people in the church. They will be there 10 years, 100 years, all their lives, but they will never get into the promised land. It doesn't mean God didn't want to bless them. It doesn't mean God was not ready to bless them. It doesn't mean God didn't have in store for them. It is their attitude towards the truth.
Amen.
How do you see things? And I'll tell you also before I finish, is the way you see things that you confess as well. Amen.
Amen.
I've never seen my mom saying that I am sick. I've never heard it from her. I am sick. Never, ever. Never. And my mom, last time I'm like, Mom, your glasses. She has had her glasses for 14 years, never changed them. And she sees well. And she said, even, you know what? Even it's only the, what do you call it? The frame that will change. I'm like, Mom, it should evolve. He said, you know, sometimes I don't even need them. What is she confessing? I'm not sick. Sickness is not in me. That's what I took from her. Sickness cannot stay in my body in Jesus' name. If it comes, it's just like you're taking a train. Let's stop that off. Hallelujah. Give a clap to the Lord. Because I'm a human being. If it comes, next stop means sickness out. That's the name of the next stop. Full stop. There's no we continue. No. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And that's how God sustains. Because those people who came with a bad report is what they saw that happened to them. Because that was their own truth. That was their own truth. But the truth of God says no. It's the promise of God. It's the plan of God. He has brought us to take us to the promised land. They should have gone there and said no. No matter what, the giant are there. There's the promised land for me. I'm looking at the promised land, not at the giant. Giant, you're there, but I don't see you.
Amen.
But most of the time, we see the giants, and the giants overtake us in our mind. Because the fact is that the truth is that they are not even there.
Amen.
Because the truth is that they were not there. They can be there, but they are not there. Because the reality that exists, that is the greatest one, is the spiritual reality.
Amen.
God could not send his people there to be eaten by giants.
Amen.
That was the reality. God is not there to kill us.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
He knew. If God knew that promised land is bad, he wouldn't have sent his people there. That was the truth. So where you are here now, this is the month we are reflecting about how we serve the Lord.
Amen.
How do you do it in truth and in spirit? Is it based on your facts? Today I'm tired, I can't do it. What you were meant to do for the Lord, you put aside because tiredness came? Because sickness came? You know, there are things God can excuse, as I always say. But there are things you will say, really? 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 And what if that day was your day? A blessing. You need to be very careful. That's the reason why if something comes, the first thing is that, before I leave my home, do you pray to go in the house of the Lord? If something comes, do you pray the day or the days before so that God will make way? Do you understand? It is all God that makes us not to live in the truth of the Lord. Amen?
Amen.
We need to become the people who live by the standards of the Lord. And let me conclude, and then we're going to pray. The Bible says that we are already saved, but what is truth? Truth is the difference between night and day. Amen?
Amen.
Night and day. That's the truth. You know why? Because the Bible says God created night, God created day. Hey, hallelujah.
Amen.
It is the difference between in and out. If you are out, you are not in. If you are in, you are not out. There are laws you cannot change. That's what the truth is. It's the difference between black and white. Even pastor come near me now, we're not going to change color. Amen?
Amen.
No, we need to make things clear. What is said by God is said by God. Man can try. If they can remove my skin and put there, it will look like, no, this is fake. Do you understand? And truth is the difference between lost and saved.
Amen.
Are you lost? Are you saved? Sitting in the church doesn't make you saved. Are you following the truth? Have you accepted the truth? Hallelujah.
Amen.
Jesus is the truth.
Amen.
The Bible is the truth. What is truth? The truth is Jesus. The truth is the Bible. Nothing else. Nothing else. Whatever you say, whatever people tell you, whatever your friends, your family, whatever tell you, is lie. Whatever you say to yourself is lie. Amen.
Amen.
It is lying if and if is not based on the truth. It's not aligned with the truth. It is not working and walking and walking by the truth. Hallelujah.
Amen.
That's why many people suffer. Jesus Christ is the truth. And if you accept those people, things in the world, whatever you hear, that those are the truth, your life as a Christian will be very poor. Very poor. With lots of ups and downs. With lots of frustrations. Not to say backsliding. Returning to the world. That's the truth. Because the truth is not something we negotiate on. You cannot negotiate between black and white. Pastor comes here, we can try. Take my skin. Let's take me on. We can try until the end finishes. It will not happen. Do you understand what I mean today? Either you are lost or either you are saved. There's no in between. People want to live in between. There's no neutrality to the Lord. It is heaven or hell.
Amen.
That's the truth.
Amen.
You know, God made things duality. He created man and woman. He didn't create in between.
Amen.
Now they're trying to do transgender. That's a man stuff. That's lie.
It's true. Amen.
Transgender what? God created man and created a woman. He didn't say, let me leave way for you to create something in between. That man is trying to create things in between. It's not going to work. Never, ever. And that's the same when we Christians, we are saved and we want to live like in the world. We become transgender Christians. After the Lord.
Amen.
And transgender is a lie. Because it's the man who becomes a woman or a woman who becomes a man. It's lie. So are you a transgender Christian? Is your faith transgender? What is the truth?
Amen?
Amen. Whatever it is, we thank God for the truth. Let's clap to the Lord this morning. Hallelujah! Clap, 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 clap to Jesus for the truth. then stand up now. I want us to reconcile with the truth and to confess the truth.